Welcome to this week's video diary. This is part of Youth Parliament, so I want to introduce you to Stella Ivory, who is the Youth MP for the Taupo electorate. How have you been finding the last couple of days, Stella?
I've actually been loving it. I was expecting it to be a really interesting experience, but it's just been really fun, really interesting, and the people especially have been really amazing.
Fantastic. So there's 121 young people here in the Parliament, one representing every MP in Parliament, and I think there's another 20 who are part of the Youth Press Gallery. So if you can hear some noise in the background, it's because the lunch for the 140-odd people is just in the room next door. But I wanted to get Stella to come and join me for this week's video diary so that you get a sense of what it's all about. And last night, we were both in the function last night that the Honourable Bill English addressed the youth MPs, and there were some really, really inspirational speakers, which was a bit of a highlight for me, as well as meeting some of the other fantastic young people like Stella that's part of the Youth Parliament.
The social event, I think my highlight was the speakers that they had come to speak to us, especially Cam.
Cerebral palsy.
He was one of the most inspirational speakers I've ever heard. Although he has this disability, he basically spoke to us about how, regardless of what comes in front of your path, if you're determined to do something and if you have decided you're going to have an amazing life, then you're going to have an amazing life. And it was just really inspirational.
That's great. One of his opening quotes was to, if you build a dream, your dream builds you. And I thought that was a really fantastic quote, and very appropriate for me, because in the Legislative Assembly, which is where the porphyry for the Youth Parliament started yesterday, that's the very room that I was in the equivalent of the Youth Parliament back in 1988, and that's when it was really reconfirmed for me that I wanted to be a Member of Parliament. So I'm sure if it's not you, Stella, there will be definitely some people in the Youth Parliament with you that end up as our Members of Parliament, don't you think?
Yeah, definitely. I think it's amazing to have the opportunity to meet all these people who are so passionate about politics already, because chances are there will be a number of them hopefully leading the country. And I've also, from this, definitely my understanding of politics has increased so much more that I think that passion's going to continue with me throughout the rest of my life. So not only has this been an amazing experience, but it definitely will transfer to the rest of my life. So it's been incredible.
Fantastic. So one of the things is the Youth MP's role continues through until December. And because I had some really fantastic candidates apply for the Youth MP, I decided to put a Youth Advisory Board together, of which Stella will lead. And there's at least one project that I'm hoping that they'll work on between now and December, because it's really obvious for me that youth are underrepresented in terms of their views here in Parliament. If you look at select committees and people who give submissions, those under 25 are really underrepresented. And as I said when I was out recruiting for my Youth MP, it's those people at that age who actually will experience and deal with the laws that we make here much longer than those perhaps in their 60s and 70s, who are often the ones that write letters to the paper, who visit their local MPs, or perhaps write submissions on legislation. So it's fantastic to see such a great group of young people, and I'm really proud that Stella is my Youth MP and doing a fantastic job in representing the Taupo electorate these few days here in Parliament.